There's been a slight change of plans. I'm going to do the welcome and then hand the microphone off to Andy. My name is Jeff Rosenberg. I'm chairman of the board. I'm class of 1980. I've been involved in school for approximately 15 years. I think I've been chairman of the board for, it seems like a lifetime, but it's about 10 years now. Is that, Andy, is that correct, 10 years? This facility is a culmination of many years of work and an indication of the success of South Kent today. And I just want to let you know that many of us here on the board, or all of us here on the board, are very proud to be standing in a facility which represents the rebirth and the growth and the success of South Kent. We stand here in a facility that is going to be named, or is named after Admiral Stockdale, and we as a school try to uphold the vision, determination, and drive that he has represented. This is a very important day for us, and at this point in time, I'd like to turn the mic over to Andy for some words. Thank you very much. We're happy to share our success with you, and we look forward to many more events like this in the future. Thank you. Thank you, John.
I will make this brief because we have speakers with far more wisdom than I who are going to come up here in just a second. I would like to welcome you all here, distinguished guests, Dr. Kissinger, Stockdale family members, Richard Lawrence, Stockdale winners, past and present, and author Mr. Townley, who will be speaking. So thank you all, gentlemen, for coming here. This is an incredible honor, and I don't want to talk with my back to you all, so I'll try to get over here. Also, welcome. We have board members from South Kent School here. We have parents. And we have many of the boys who will be playing in this arena standing back there. So thank you all for coming. And I need to point out, I just remembered this, I need to point out the evacuation route, just in case. Is our building inspector here? Just in case. All right. The evacuation route is back out that way. In case something happens, not that it will, but in case it does, you see the exit sign back there? That is the route we go. And you can also go right out here. There are two. I had to do that, so it's all right. So there we are. All right. With no further ado, it is my great honor to ask Dr. Henry Kissinger to speak. He was an amazing part of the story, and we are so honored to have him here. Dr. Kissinger.
I always wondered about the question, can you hear me? Because those who can't answer. Well, we are neighbors from just down the road, and we're very proud of you. And I'm especially proud that I've been invited to speak here about Admiral Stockdale. Which for me, the powerful member of the family was Sybil Stockdale. The Admiral was a great man for whom I had tremendous admiration, but Sybil was something else. And let me tell you why I feel that strong. I became National Security Advisor in 1969. The war in Vietnam had gone on at that time for 8 years, more or less, certainly for four. And James Stockdale was captured, shot down in 65. By the time Nixon became president, and I did, was had the honor of becoming security advisor. The war had been going on for 4 years, the big time war and the lower military engagement for 8 years. The country was divided in a way that you cannot imagine today, with demonstrations, with most of the academic community joining demonstrators, and with constant implications that the government was missing opportunities to end the war. Nobody had a greater interest in ending the war than the president and myself. But there was one thing we wouldn't do. We would not turn over the people who had relied on us to communist rule. We insisted that the people of Vietnam have their choice of government. That was the only issue. I mention all of this because I met Sybil, because there was a league of families of prisoners who were in Vietnam. And I met with them every 2 months, about 100 women. And they'd come into the White House. And on the way to the White House, on the way to the White House, there were all these groups that were telling them to give us help. And on the way out of the White House, there were all these journalists, and they were all waiting for these ladies to say the administration was not doing enough, and if they just make one more concession, but Sybil wouldn't have it. And she held these ladies together. And they were, people, or the two sons who are here, it's such a great joy for me. The two sons said thank you for your support of Sybil. That's nonsense. She was supportive of me because it meant an enormous amount to Nixon and me. And this is a war we inherited, that we hadn't started, to bring it to an honorable conclusion of which the men who were in prison could be proud. And so I was, on the one hand, it was anguish to meet these wives. On the other hand, it was uplifting because of Sybil. And so that's how it started. And then I got to know the object of all these activities. And he was a man whose character was worthy of the suffering. I became afterwards a particularly close friend of Senator McCain because when I was in Hanoi at the end of the war, I was given the opportunity to take him out with me on a presidential flight by the Vietnamese. And I refused. I said he has to get in line with all the others and he will have to come out in turn. You have to remember, if I take out the son of the Pacific Fleet Commander as a person. So I was wondering what would McCain say to me when I met him. And we met at the White House lawn where Admiral Stockdale was also. And McCain walked up to me and said, thank you for saving my honor. And it wasn't just his honor. It was above all the honor of the Stockdales and the innumerable others who lived under these barbaric conditions and kept their faith in their country, and who had known that this was about freedom and about the importance of America. And then I saw the Admiral. He didn't become Admiral right away. At the War College, and we saw each other over the years, and he was always a symbol of the best in America, of what makes its country worth fighting for. A man who believed in freedom, who believed in his country, and who believed in the importance of our values around the world. And he did his job unostentatiously. And if you had congratulated him on doing his job, he wouldn't even have understood it, because he was doing his duty. It was the natural thing for him to do. So I want to thank Kent, and all of you for giving me this opportunity to pay tribute to a couple in a time when we are always talking of our divisions and our uncertainties. They knew what they owed each other. They knew what they owed each other. And I cannot tell you how much it meant to me when I walked into that first meeting of the League and Sybil was standing there, keeping order. But in a motherly way, I mean, this was a great lady. And then her husband was worthy of it. So they are an example of what our country needs, what made our country great. And I cannot tell you how much it means to me to be permitted to say a few words about these two extraordinary people.
POWs Jim Stockdale was able to lead. We got a group of guys known as the Alcatraz 11. And I've spent the past year or two getting to know these men at Admiral Stockdale, and it's been a transformative experience for me, because when I was old enough to be here in South Kent, and I wish my parents in Atlanta had sent me up here, but they didn't, but at Lakeside High School in Atlanta, Georgia, and my heroes carried swords and rode white horses. Now, I went to Washington and Lee University, which is basically a chapel to George Washington and Robert E. Lee. And those, to me, were heroes. My heroes flew off aircraft carriers in World War II and won dogfights over the Pacific. And leaders, to me, looked like Dwight Eisenhower. They had the dash of George Patton. But then I met these POWs. I learned about Admiral Stockdale. And now, my heroes wore pajamas and flip-flops. My heroes were wounded aviators who were shot down, and they were beaten, were half-starved, who were dirty, and they got tortured again and again, and they came back again and again. The greatest leaders I've ever known fought the longest battle any U.S. serviceman has ever fought. And they fought it with as much valor, as much ferocity as Americans showed on the beaches of Normandy or the streets of Fallujah. They just did it for 8 long years. So I was thinking about Admiral Stockdale, and when he was shot down in the unknowns that he faced. What a burden. How was he going to lead these men in this bizarre situation that no one had ever anticipated? There were more than 500 Americans who were ultimately POWs in North Vietnam, and Admiral Stockdale had to lead them. So the question was, how was he going to do it? So everybody can just raise their right hand for a second. All right, point your finger up. Now, I want everybody to put their finger on their chin. All right, there are a lot of you putting your fingers on your cheek because people follow what people do. So if you hear somebody telling you to do something, but they're doing something else, you're not going to follow them. And Admiral Stockdale knew this, and Admiral Stockdale was the first guy to take a punch. He was the first guy to start a hunger strike. He was the first guy to put himself in jeopardy and to show his men how to survive, how to go through this ordeal for as long as it was going to take. And they never knew how long it was going to take. They never knew when they were going to come home. They just knew that whenever that day came, they were going to return with honor. Admiral Stockdale led them there. So when you think about the difference that he made and the difference that we're all going to make, the legacy we're going to leave is not going to be the words that we say, or in my case, the words we write. It's going to be the actions that we make. So I hope that everyone who comes through these doors, who plays on this ice, who sees these panels, thinks about that. Thinks about the legacy they are leaving through their actions. And Jim Stockdale and his wife Sybil and all the POWs from the Vietnam era. And gave us a wonderful example of how to be a leader. Thank you very much.
That was fantastic. Thank you. And Mr. Townley's book that he did not talk about that I would like to mention, the book, his latest book is called Defiant, the POWs who endured Vietnam's most infamous prison, the women who fought for them, and the one who never returned. So, thank you. Well done. Our next speaker is the 1996 recipient of the Vice Admiral James Bond Stockdale Award for Inspirational Leadership and the former president of the Naval War College. And this is Vice Admiral James Wisecup.
Kissinger, family members of the Stockdale family, and the folks here at South Kent, I can't tell you how honored I am to be here today. And to the boys who are going to play hockey in this place, let me tell you a couple things. I'm of the generation who knew Admiral Stockdale as a young ensign. I had lunch with him in Charleston, South Carolina, first time I met him when he was there, and I had a chance to see him on a couple of other occasions. But let me tell you about the Stockdale Award. The Stockdale Award, as Dr. Kissinger mentioned, it had to do with honor. And the thing about the Stockdale Award is it's given to you by your buddies. You're picked by your buddies. It's probably the most meaningful because of that. It's not, you weren't picked out of a pool. You were selected by people who are doing the same thing as you. And that's a wonderful thing. The other connection I had with Admiral Stockdale was going through the Naval War College. And by that time, he had already put in place a course called the Foundations of Moral Obligation, in which he had us read the classics and read great philosophers. And it changed my thinking having come right from command at sea. And when I went back to command, I thought very, very differently. So, guys, I'll tell you, you're going to play a lot of hockey in this place, and people are going to say, where are you going to go? And the fact that you're going to the James and Sybil Stockdale Arena should mean something, okay? So I charge all of you to remember the story and remember what you've heard here, because it has to do with honor, and it has to do with keeping faith with your buddies. Thank you.
That is a great message. Thank you. Our next speaker is Commander Thomas J. Dickinson, the 2014 recipient of the Vice Admiral James Stockdale Award for Inspirational Leadership. Commander Dickinson.
Good morning, Dr. Kissinger, Stockdale family, Admiral Wisecup, distinguished guests, students and families. It's great to be here at South Kent today. I'm really honored, especially to be present with the Stockdale family. Admiral Stockdale is a hero in our Navy and a hero in our country, and has been since I was 17 years old. That's when I left a small town in Michigan to start my plebe summer at the Naval Academy. I started that off, and one of the first things you do at the Naval Academy is you have to memorize a book called The Brief Points. A lot of naval tradition, facts, trivia in that book, all in there for a reason. But the most important thing that we have to memorize is the code of conduct. And that code of conduct within the first 2 weeks of plebe summer was memorized by every midshipman, something we hold very close to us. That's the first time I heard the story of Admiral Stockdale, and heard the story of a Navy pilot who shot down and 7.5 years in captivity as a prisoner of war. Majority of that in a cell that's 3 foot by 9 foot. As a 17-year-old, first of all, 7.5 years was kind of hard to get your head around. It's hard to think, almost half of my life in captivity in something that small. And it makes you reflect on how can somebody get through that? And where the heroism comes in is he not only got through it, but he led through that time period. 10 other prisoners of war in there with him, and he led through that experience, and he maintained his dignity and his integrity the entire time. So we have a direct connection with a legacy. I mean, if you look at the Naval Academy today, we have the Stockdale Center of Ethical Leadership, and right in front of Luce Hall is a statue of Admiral Stockdale. If you go to the War College in Newport, Rhode Island, we have the Stockdale group program that Admiral Wisecup just mentioned. Right there, that changes our future and molds our brightest military leaders for our future. If you go to San Diego, California, we have USS Stockdale, one of the newest guided missile destroyers in our fleet, DDG 106. That ship is going to be in our Navy for at least another 35 years. I could give a million more examples. There are countless. But the bottom line is, Admiral Stockdale's legacy is enduring. It's going to be around forever. He could have retired at the end of his prisoner of war experience, and that legacy would have been established. But he continued to serve on, both in uniform and out of uniform, and we have a legacy and a tradition to live up to. That direct connection here at South Kent is something special, and this school is something special. This is my first time in South Kent, and I can see it. And I'm proud of all of these young men here who are going to be our leaders in our future. So I'm proud to be a part of this. I'm proud to be associated with the Stockdale name that carries enormous value. And thank you very much for your time today. Thank you, Commander Dickinson. Next, we will hear from Richard H. Lawrence, Jr., class of 1974. And it was Richard and his wife, Dee, right over there. Dee, can you put your hand up, please? That's Dee. It was their idea to name this the Admiral James and Sybil Stockdale Arena. So to them, we owe a great honor. Thank you. Richard, tell us about it.
it's an incredible honor to be sitting here at South Penn with Dr. Kissinger and the Stockdale family, Andy and the other recipients of the Stockdale Award, Mr. Townley. To begin with, though, I'd like to thank everybody who have contributed to this great event. And it's not just the people here. There have been a huge effort that's gone into this. Without the generous efforts, we wouldn't be here today. And so my appreciation and gratitude is really boundless. When Andy, my wife Dee, and I met in San Francisco and spoke about naming the new hockey arena, we felt we needed an iconic symbol that would speak to both the essence of South Kent School and also provide a powerful message for the students on the hillside. And by gosh, I think we got it just about right. So I only met Admiral Stockdale and his wife Sybil on one occasion, but their history cast a long shadow over many parts of my life. And it's my hope that these panels will have an equally striking impact on those who come to play, study, and learn about life on this campus in the years to come. If you look on panel 3, in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see an odd equation that was sewn into Admiral Stockdale's wartime flight jacket. Yeah, it took me quite a while to figure out what that was. N over the square root of theta. Well, Ma Brown's geometry class never prepared me for that. I eventually found the meaning in a speech that Sid, his son and classmate of mine in South Kent, made on a dedication of a statue to his father at the U.S. Naval Academy in Annapolis. Let me share it with you. In fighter pilot language, N stands for maximum engine thrust, while the square root of theta is limitless and immeasurable. For Admiral Stockdale, this symbolized boundless energy, calm resolve, and ultimate confidence. Wow. N over the square root of theta also reminded me of what Andy and his team are doing here at South Kent School. That is to help educate energetic young men and provide them the confidence to face the challenges of life with a calm resolve, in an ethical manner, and with ultimate confidence. On panel 6, you can see a reference there to Back US. And this was an acronym for Admiral Stockdale's military orders for all of the POWs. Initially, I thought that Back US was Admiral Stockdale's commitment to get all the POWs back home safely. But no, it was something entirely different. Back US was Admiral Stockdale's shorthand. Let me share it with you. B, don't bow in public. A, stay off the air, meaning don't allow yourself to be turned into propaganda from the North Vietnamese. C, admit no crime. K, don't kiss up to camp authority. And lastly, US, unity over self. And it's this unity over self that I'd like everybody to think about for a few minutes. We live in a world today driven by hedonistic interests, a sense of entitlement, a need for instantaneous gratification, and a constant me-first world. Yet when I look around and look at those that I love, those that I know, those that I've worked with, I see that their success has come because of the us, not the me. Teams that came together over the course of a season, classmates that worked hard on a project together in the classroom, colleagues who collaborated to solve a vexing problem in a business setting, friendships, marriages, professional lives, all of these require a community, a shared commitment, a band of brothers to achieve success, Andy's hero's journey, or better said, unity over self. Almost everybody here can close their eyes and feel the cold, dreary winter mornings at South Kent School, when yet more Latin classes lay ahead and home-cooked meals lay way too far off in the future. At that time, George Bartlett, who was headmaster at South Kent when I was here, with perfect timing, would introduce generations of students to a Latin phrase that most of you will instantaneously recognize. Illegitimus non corporundum. Don't let the bastards get you down. To me, this was one of the powerful messages and one of the powerful lessons that I learned on this campus that has served me well my entire life. Life doesn't always go our way. There are days of sadness, days of defeat, days of disappointment, but when that happens, I want South Kent students and future generations of South Kent students to wander down and explore these panels and explore and understand how Admiral Stockdale didn't let his captors get him down. Despite years in isolation, sleeping in leg irons, and enduring indescribable torture. So in closing, when Sid and Taylor and Andy and I and my wife Dee began to put our ideas down for these display panels, our collective ambition was that this generation and future generations of South Kent students would be inspired by their words, their images, the legacy, that students would ponder the significance of a particular photo or one of the many quotes, or more deeply explore the difficult lessons of history or the philosophy of Epictetus. But I also hoped that when opposing hockey teams enter the Admiral James and Sybil Stockdale Arena and they walk by these panels and they see the words honor, courage, and commitment, that they're going to understand that South Kent School is no ordinary school, but a Stockdale school. And they're about to confront, on this ice right here, the power of N over the square root of theta. So my thanks go out to all of you here that have helped make South Kent such a special place. Thank you.
Of the my parents' sons, and I graduated from South Kent in 1981. So to see the students here is really great. I can promise you this: this rink was not named because I was a good hockey player. That's I'm getting a lot of grief from my classmates. Actually, they're being all too kind. But I wanted to thank first of all Mr. Vadnais for this incredible honor, and of course Mr. Lawrence and Mrs. Lawrence for their extraordinary generosity to the Board of Trustees. It's a huge honor, of course. And you know, we're here really to honor my mom and my dad, and Dr. Kissinger, those remarks about my mom were so meaningful. And for all of that resolve she had in the White House, she had even more, I think, on A Avenue in Coronado with her kids. So I know those looks well. But I wanted to also say a few words about my brother Sid here, who is my older brother. And so the way it happened is when my dad went away, he was on a cruise, and then he was shot down over Vietnam. I was 3 years old when he left, and I was almost 11 when he came back. So I didn't really know him when he left. I didn't know him at all, honestly. And so when he came back, I gained a father, and it was wonderful, and we developed a great relationship over the long term. But my older brothers, I think, had a harder time because they lost a dad, and then they got him back. And I think that's, you know, when I think about South Kent, I love my years here, but when Sid was here as my older brother, he was really kind of the dad to me. He kind of filled that void of, you know, being somebody that I could get excited about and do all sorts of great things in the absence of having a father. And so, you know, I know this is the Admiral and Sybil Stockdale Arena, and I think that's terrific, but to me it's also about my brother Sid and everything he... And I think that the story in that is that, you know, for the kids, for the students here, something that I learned at South Kent, and I hope, and I'm sure you're learning it as well, is you are your brother's keeper, right? You're here to take care of yourself, but also your friends. And that you generate a lot of fulfillment in life if you dedicate yourself to that. And so, you know, I remember so clearly dropping Sid off here, and the dorm was above the old study hall. I'm not sure what the name of the building is now, but I guess it's the student center, right? The third form dorm was on top of that building, and it was just one room with a bunch of bunk beds. That's all it was. And I remember driving, and I was literally, I don't know how old it was, maybe 6 or 7 years old. And I remember driving away with my mom and my other brother, and how emotional my mom got driving down Bulls Bridge Road. And as a kid, I remember seeing my mom get emotional for the first time. And I think that memory is so important to me because it really drives home the fact that this is an incredibly emotional place for me and my family. It's a bedrock of our life. To have this arena here means so much to the legacy of my parents, but also to me personally. And again, I just want to thank my brother, Sid, for being there when I needed it the most. So I'll introduce Sid now. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I'm truly humbled and honored to be here today with my brother Taylor to represent our parents and our family at this wonderful occasion. Let me begin by thanking the people responsible for making the Stockdale Arena a reality, as well as those who joined us today to mark this dedication. First, thanks to Andy Vadnais, Board Chair Jeff Rosenberg, and all the members of the South Kent Board of Trustees. The campus looks fantastic. And it is the result of your hard work that the school continues to thrive. To our speakers today, Commander Tom Dickinson, Alvin Townley, Vice Admiral Philip Wisecup, thank you for your thoughtful words of praise for my parents and in helping to frame the historical meaning of this dedication. That story, my parents' story, is very powerful and it contains important lessons for the future leaders of our country. Thank you for keeping their story and the values they contain alive. And to Dr. Kissinger and Mrs. Kissinger, thank you very much for joining us. Few in the audience would have known that in the darkest days of our father's imprisonment, when my mother was fighting for formal acknowledgement of the mistreatment of the POWs, it was Dr. Kissinger who was instrumental in helping her cause and bring my father and the other POWs home with honor. My gratitude to you is boundless. And although my mother's health issues preclude her from attending today, I know she sends her warmest regards to both of you. I also want to thank Ms. Jamie Jett Walker, who's here tonight, today. Where's Jamie? Where are you, Jamie? There you are. For her passionate effort in constructing the story panels that are here and will ultimately permanently be displayed inside of this viewing area behind us. They portray the story of my parents' journey and triumph during the Vietnam era. And even the photographic renderings displayed today reveal Jamie's stunning work. Thanks also to my wife, Nancy, who's here. Who I met 40 years ago this fall, 1 year after I graduated from South Kent School. She has lived the Stockdale story right beside me, and my life is so much richer because of her love and support. And lastly, to Dee and Richard Lawrence and all the other benefactors of South Kent School, who by their generosity made the creation of this beautiful new hockey arena possible. Thank you. The opportunities you have created by your gift are the bounty of all South Kent students, now and in the future. When my good friend Richard Lawrence called to tell me he wanted to name this arena for my parents, I felt an overwhelming sense of appreciation and gratitude. It's a great honor, and it's a perfect fit. You've heard it already. My parents' journey, the challenges they overcame by their loyalty, toughness, faith, and resolve, these parallel the values and ethics that are at the core of a South Kent education. I know my mother and father are thrilled to be associated with this great school, and I'm proud to have their story, our family story, remembered in this meaningful and lasting way. You, current students of South Kent, are the recipients of this unique gift, and I know you will care for it and make both my parents and your parents and loved ones proud. When the destroyer USS Stockdale was christened in Bath, Maine in May 2008, the keynote speaker, Admiral Patrick Walsh, Vice Chief of Operations, addressed a portion of his remarks to the officers and crew, and I think they have equal meaning for you students of South Kent. Admiral Walsh said, "Life at sea has taught us that the battleground for what we do is in the day-to-day. And while the mission has moments that seem tedious and the daily grind is sometimes mundane, the habits we form reflect the most important choices we make. For each day, we choose to either blunt or sharpen our skills. Admiral Stockdale taught us that we cannot summon these skills in a moment of crisis if we have squandered them by complacency, inconsistency, or the compromise of professional values." Close quote. I know firsthand that life for a South Kent student is like being at sea. It's easy to feel that the daily grind is mundane and has no purpose or value. But remember that the habits you form and the choices you make every day are of utmost importance. The development of good habits and sound character, these are among the most important parts of your education at South Kent. One quote from Heraclitus embedded in the Stockdale panels over here says it best. "The content of your character is your choice. Day by day, what you choose, what you think, and what you do is who you become. Man's character is his fate." Students of South Kent, remember who you are. Appreciate your family and their story and your place in your journey. And thank those, please, who have given you the opportunity to attend South Kent School. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sid. Fantastic. And thank you to all of our speakers. And now I would like to ask Father Stephen Klots to come up and actually do the blessing. Father.
Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for the lives and work of Admiral James and Sybil Stockdale, their example of faith, loyalty, camaraderie, and courage. And we pray that those same virtues may resound in this new rink, now named in their honor. We ask that you bless this rink to your use, and that you make it a place of joy, friendship, competition, and grit. May all who skate here, may all who play here, May all who coach here, may all who cheer on games here, do so in a way that is pleasing to you. And in doing so, may they grow in the knowledge of your kingdom. This we pray in your holy name. Amen.
Thank you, Father. And that concludes our dedication ceremony. That was one of the most moving that I have ever seen. Thank you, all of you, Dr. Kissinger and Stockdale's representatives of the Navy, Author Townley, and of course, Richard and Dee Lawrence. This will go down as one of the great days in the 91-year history of South Kent School. Thank you all for being here.